This week's Farm Basics is brought to you by SatShot.com. Satellites aren't just for NASA anymore. Use the power of satellite imagery to create variable rate management zones in your fields. To reduce input costs and increase yields on your farm, go to SatShot.com.
Our Farm Basics topic today is minimizing spring flooding. Now, Brian, when you came up with this idea, were you thinking you're going to control nature now, or what's going on?
Yep, I am. You know, we can handle nature to some degree. Now, certainly, we're not going to take care of all the problems, but we definitely can manage some of the things that are out there. So the reason why we're talking about this and minimizing spring flooding is, let's look back just 1 year ago and what happened up in the Red River Valley. In the Fargo, North Dakota area, they had some of the worst flooding that they've ever had. Now, I'm not going to say that I could have prevented all that, but what I am going to say is, if farmers in that whole area had drain tile and had proper drainage systems, the flooding could have been minimized. We still would have most likely had some flooding. The problem with the Red River is it runs north. Okay, so when things start to melt in the south, do you really think they're going to be melted up in Canada? I doubt it. So when you've got a river that runs north in the northern hemisphere, you're most likely always going to have some issues. All I'm saying is we can minimize a lot of those things, not just in that area, but across the country with proper farm drainage.
Well, farm drainage is certainly one of the most misunderstood topics in our country, I know for sure. When you talk about farm drainage, there are a lot of misconceptions out there, both from farmers and from other people in the community, wondering, how does this really work? So we thought we'd start by explaining that.
Well, what it comes down to is we put drainage tile in the ground in a lot of cases. Now, certainly you can do surface drainage too, but the main thing we wanted to focus on here was drainage tile, because that's the most misunderstood part of farm drainage. Anyway, when we put drainage tile in the ground, we're putting it usually at a depth of 3 to 6 feet deep in the ground. The purpose of that drainage tile is to take away excess water in the soil. As farmers, we want to conserve as much moisture as possible out in our fields. We definitely do not want to get rid of all the water. But by putting these tile lines out there, usually one every 50 feet or every 70 feet out in the field, and in some cases, it might just be a few lines over a whole field. It's not a real big deal, but we want to have a few of these lines out there to take care of excess water. The reason why we want to get rid of the excess water is this. Soil naturally is like a sponge. It can absorb water, and then as our crop needs it, it releases that water for the crop to use. It's a great thing. But the problem is, if our soil gets 100% saturated, not only will our plants suffer, because plants can't survive when there's no oxygen in the soil. The other problem is, when we get a rain, if that ground is 100% saturated, the rain lands, where does it go? Well, if it can't soak into the ground, it has to run off. And when it runs off, that leads to soil erosion. We lose our soil. We lose any chemical or fertilizer that's on there. All that stuff, that's bad for the environment downstream. By adding tile and doing it in the right way, we can make our field back into a sponge. We can keep all that soil, the chemical, the fertilizer, everything in the field. That's a good deal for everyone.
Well, this spring in many parts of the country, there's going to be quite a bit of snow to melt, and that snow has to go somewhere, and it's also going to be accompanied by spring rains. And when you think about in the spring, how is improving that farm drainage going to change things, Brian?
Well, the biggest thing is we want to try to get rid of excess water in the fall. Our problem in 2009 in the fall was we had a lot of moisture. Where's that water going to go? It has absolutely no choice. It has to run off. That's the whole problem, and that's what we're getting at today. If farmers improve their drainage all across the country, they will get rid of excess water at times when we can get rid of the excess water. It's pretty easy to get water into the streams in the fall. There's never any problem with flooding or anything like that. Almost all the flooding that occurs in the Midwest happens in the springtime when that snowmelt comes. So again, we want to have good farm drainage. We can get rid of that excess water in the fall. So now when spring comes, our soils can be a sponge. We can absorb a lot of that spring rain and the snowfall that's melting. That's a good thing.
Well, minimizing spring flooding is a really big deal for everyone in the community, but also weed control is important too. We'll show you how to control this tough weed later in the show.